Hey, it's the title card for the show, and I don't have a proper intro yet. Yay.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to this. This is Spyro the Dragon. This is my show. Welcome. So this is just going to be me playing some games, because I like playing games. Figured I'd start with Spyro, because it's one of the first games I ever played, so yeah. Here we go. I'll probably shut up for the cutscene and make some snarky comments, because why the fuck not? In the world of dragons. I'm Reese, by the way. Welcome to whatever the fuck this is. Yeah, look at that boom mic, man. Shit. Get that shit out of shot. That's some shoddy production values. Spyro, hi. There he is in the background. Fuck that sheep. Fuck that entire sheep. Yeah, so welcome to this. Oh, that's the big blue dragon. He is voiced by Clancy Brown, who plays frickin' Mr. Krabs. Yeah, Spyro, hi. And there's Nasty Nork. Lovely. I should probably turn the sound on so I know what the fuck's going on. Yeah, you do, Spyro. Yeah, you do. All your friends been turned to crystal. Why are you friends with a bunch of adult dragons, anyway? Why are you the only child? Never thought about that. The adventure begins. Yeah, it does. In a lot of ways. Now, hopefully, this will work. I had a little problem recording before, but yeah. So, let's free the first dragon. Nesta. I knew a dude named Nesta.
Thank you for releasing me, Spyro.
No problems, man.
Then find the balloonist. He'll transport you to the next world.
Okay.
I'm going after him.
He sounds like Proto Sonic. He sounds like fucking... Okay, actually, Sonic came before this. He sounds like, you know, gotta go fast kind of Sonic, you know? So yeah, this is a pretty easy game. Like, I'm not that great at many video games, but I consider myself pretty good at this. If the camera will work with me, which it probably won't, you know, that would just be too easy. So yeah, basic thing in this game, collect all the gems, save old dragons, beat old bosses. And we're going for 100%, because fuck anything else, right? Right? Like, yeah, man. The camera in this game is awful. Oh, God. I've recently been playing other Spyro games, and I forgot how shitty, like, the camera and certain movements in this game are. That's just me, though. I'm picky. I can't even hover. Shit. Forgot about that. Okay. Try that again. I'm not getting that. Fuck me. Okay. Says I'm good at this game. Brags about the fact that I'm fucking good at this game, and immediately hits an edge. Yeah! Yeah, fucking did it. Good job, me. Okay, so the basics of Spyro, right? Sheep die, they produce butterflies, and Sparks the dragonfly there, the little yellow thing following around, he eats. Did I say butterflies or dragonflies? Whichever, it produces butterflies, Sparks eats them. Because why the fuck wouldn't he? Hey, another dragon. It's Delbin. Holy shit, you're huge!
I'll torch you!
Keep your horns on,
I'll
Spyro!
Torch you.
You have much to learn first! Do you know what the
Spyro! That's frickin' Mr. Krabs again. Shit, son.
Keep an eye on him and see what I mean.
Yeah. Thanks, man. Good to know. Okay, watch this. Wait, why is it not working? Is supposed to, like, aren't these supposed to light up? Oh, okay, never mind. I did it anyway. Didn't even know what the fuck I was doing, and hey, it's a speedway. I will not be going there yet, because fuck that shit. Now I'm gonna go collect all the gems and save all the dragons in this world, because, you know, that's what you gotta do. You gotta get all the collectibles. These old collectathon games are great. Like, they just give you a bunch of shit to do. I love them. I'm, you know. I played this a lot. I played a lot of Crash Bandicoot when I grew up. In fact, we're probably going to play Crash Bandicoot after I finish this episode. So that'll be fun. Super pumped for Yooka-Laylee. That's me dating this video. Yooka-Laylee's coming out in a couple days. Super pumped for the Crash Insane Trilogy. Yeah, boy. That's gonna provide me hours of entertainment. I'm gonna go save this dragon now. Yeah. Tomas. Hello, Spyro.
Hey, Spyro.
Hello, Spyro. I am a collectible, so the player's never going to listen to what you're saying. Or what I'm saying. Fuck. I'm good at this. Can you tell that this is my first episode? I'm not nervous at all. I'm not shitting myself. This is fine. This is absolutely fine. I'm fine. Hey, let's go up this whirlwind. Isn't this just beautiful? This is a nice little whirlwind that takes you up to Town Square. What town and what square? Like, what town square am I going to? It's got bulls in it. I remember, that's a level that has bulls in it. What town square has bulls? Like seriously, man. So I'm new to this whole comedy thing. Could you tell? Most of my shit's gonna be pretty self-deprecating because I have no idea what the fuck I'm doing. I'm just, you know, I'm sitting here. I'm talking into a phone, playing a game that I played roughly a million times. Yeah, just rolling around at the speed of sound. Got places to go. Got to follow my rainbow. And, enjoying it. Expect many, many more Sonic references. Whenever I get my, so my PS2's broken, right? I fucked it up somehow. And whenever I actually get it fixed, I'm gonna start playing through the, Sonic games at some point.
The artisan's boss is through a portal in the dragon mouth.
Oh, great.
Not yet ready, Spyro. First,
bitch!
Complete one of the other artisan lands.
Who says I'm not ready to face a boss? I mean, you know, this is meant to be semi-open world. I can go face a boss when I want. Yeah, okay, that's a lie. This game is not open world. There's no Spyro game that's open world. Fuck that shit, man. Ugh. It gives the illusion of open world, because you have so many different places you can go in one place. That's what I didn't always kind of like about the Spyro games, you know? Just, like, the illusion of open worldedness, if that makes sense, you know? Like, making you think you've got more control than you do. In reality, you're stuck painfully behind walls. I love that this was considered a friggin' technological 3D marvel for the PlayStation back when it came out. And now PlayStation's making fucking Horizon Zero Dawn. You know who you can thank for Horizon Zero Dawn? Insomniac, for making this game. I'm gonna go play a world now. Stonehill. I know you, Stonehill. Hey, we're flying! I never understood the portals. Like, I love them, but I never understood them. Like, he can't fly in any other situation except when he's going through a portal going into a speedway. Never got that. And goodbye, Mr. Ram. One thing I do always appreciate in these games is the villain design. They're also, like, unique. Like, really different from anything else. Like, Super Mario 64, you got a lot of the same enemies. And that's a generalization. That's a hella generalization. Like, but Super Mario 64, you got a lot of repeated enemies, and same thing with, Sonic Adventure, which I think also came out around this time, but in Spyro, each world had unique enemies, and I really appreciated that, you know? Like, uniqueness in a game that is fairly old and simple, but, you know, it's cool. I'm just freaking blathering, man. I hope someone, like, if I do put this up on YouTube, which I kind of plan to, I hope someone appreciates this, whatever the fuck it is I'm doing.
When you free a dragon or step on one of their platforms, you're saving your progress. That could be useful if you run into trouble.
Oh, yeah. I should save my game. Thank you, random dragon. That, you know. I was gonna make a joke about how, like, no one remembers what the dragons say because they are effectively just collectibles, but that guy, he helped me out. Good on him. Thanks, man. Thank you so much. That is hella helpful. Okay, where the fuck am I going? This is the way to the exit. I remember this. Right, that's the exit of the level. And then, like, the rest of the level's further away, on the other side. Love that little noise. Never appeared in any other Spyro game, but I always enjoyed the frickin', you just got an extra life noise. Asta! That's such a cool name for a dragon.
Hey, Spyro, I'm your grandpa! How you doing, Sunny Jim?
You sound so fucking old.
Yeah. Look at me in my puppy mouth. I'm cute as a button.
Okay. Oh, I remember this. Yeah, there's a key down here. Fuck yeah. I'm so excited about finding a key, goddamn. I remember finding this originally. Like, I say I played this a lot as a kid, but I kept replaying, like, the same three levels because I never saved my progress. But I remember, I think the first time I actually beat it, I was a bit older. And I remember finding that and being, like, so amazed with myself because, like, never thought to go look down the side of the end of the level for extra shit and find a beach. Never thought of that. No, don't t- you can get fucked. Okay. We're going back down here, and we're gonna open this dragon dude up. Gavin! It's Gavin from Achievement Hunter, oh my god.
His color indicates his power. When he eats butterflies, he stays strong. Like me.
Strong. Like me. You should have had a Russian accent. If you're saying a line strong like me, you gotta have a Russian accent. Strong like me. Spyro looks like he's enjoying the ride. Charging around at the speed of a dragon. Purple dragon. Hey, look, it's the whole rest of the level. Frickin' not lost for words at all. I know exactly what I'm gonna say. Hey, that's a different ow. God damn it. Okay. Hey, why are the village shepherds? What? I love the death animation. Oh, it's funny. Okay, let's see if I can charge these bosses. Yeah, get fucked. My horns are better than yours. Sharper, apparently. Sparks don't want to eat no dragon. Fuck. I nearly called them dragonflies again. They're fucking butterflies. Sparks is the dragonfly. Get your shit together, Reese. Come on, man. Whoa. That was delayed as shit. Okay. Where are we going? We're going over here. Yeah, we are. Okay. Yay! I'm on top of the world, ma. And we found another dragon. Gildas.
Spyro, my friend. How
I love his color scheme. Oh my god.
You bet.
For the longest glide, press the X button at the top of a jump. And try pressing the triangle button to drop down in mid-flight.
Just casually stop mid-flight, like, oh yeah, just flying on, oops! The amounts of time, because in later games the triangle button is the fucking hover button, which allows you to just sort of, like, you know, try and get a little height after you've glided for a bit. Like, it's meant to help you get up to extra ledges. In this game it's just like, you just fall. No fun. No fun at all. Oh, there's a thief. Okay, I'm gonna wreck this son of a bitch. Come here. Come the fuck here. Yeah. I have played these games so much that I've just... Thieves do not phase me. You know what phases me? Invisible fucking walls. That is phasing. I wish I could phase through and go and see the wide open expanses of... wherever the fuck I... Stone Hill. I'm on Stone Hill. Be great to see the rest of Stone Hill. It looks so expansive and gorgeous. I'm literally just... Have I got all the dragons yet? I think I did. I think I went and got all the dragons. Yeah. Okay. As you can tell, I'm very good at keeping track of my own progress in these games. How many inventory? 200 gems. Okay, I'm close. No! Ah! I did not mean to do that! Ah, that's annoying. Great job, Reese. Good, good. That number's not going to annoy you at all. Okay, we're going back in. Fuck me. Just wasting time. Just straight up wasting everyone's time here. Good job. Good, good job. Wasting your own time. This is only a half hour video, you know? Like, I could be getting close to... Oh, fuck. Yeah, that was great. That was a good death. Okay, so you notice how the enemies are dropping like little spheres instead of fucking gems now? That means you beat them once. That's the game like recognizing that you beat them once already. So it's like, hey, we're gonna give you these little things, and if you collect like, I don't know, 20 or something of them, you get an extra life, and that's, you know, cool. It's a nice way of keeping track of like whether you've actually killed something or not. You know, like having your own hit list and shit. Where is that lost gem? I need it. Lost couple of gems, actually. I'm a couple low, which is annoying. I need to find the last few gems. Oh, here we go. That it? Yeah, that's... No, I'm one short. No! Where is the lost gem? I need it! I see you, bitch. Yeah! 200 of 200. Beautiful. Yes, I'm a fucking perfectionist. At least when it comes to Spyro games. And some Crash games. All except the first Crash game, because the first Crash game can get fucked. It's so hard. And yet, I'm gonna play it next. You know, me, eating my own words. Okay, we're done with Stone Hill. Let's charge on over to the next level. Unless we're running out of time. Are we running out of time? I don't know. We're only 17... Whoa, hi. Wow, I'm recording this on my phone, so if it sounds shitty or you hear me, like, making noise, that's probably it. Dark Hollow. Dark and Hollow. Jesus. That is not a good mix. Like, okay, not in, like, a racist way or anything. I'm not racist. Fuck you. That is another thing I like about Spyro. Anything that's got, like, shiny on it, like that shiny reflective surface, that means you gotta charge it. But then in later games, they change it up. Like, they make you think you gotta charge him, but in actuality, maybe you don't. Maybe you just gotta, like, flame him in a different area. Actually, they do that in this game, too. Shit, this game's genius. I love it. Oh, right there. See, he's wearing shinies, but you gotta flame his ass, because his ass is unprotected. Yeah. Holy fuck, you are huge and terrifying, and get the fuck away from me, bitch. Yeah. I flamed your butt. Yeah, dude. Hey, that's a key. Hey, I hit my head. Just like falls to death. Just nothing. What the flying fuck? Okay, we got this. We got these gems. Some radioactive blue, some fucking toxic blue water right there. That is beautiful for the eyes. And all the gems, and yeah! Save fucking Oswin! What is this, Doctor Who? I'm funny. My mom says I'm funny. By the way, like, okay, I should probably clear this up in the first episode. People tell me I have an accent. I am Australian. I live in Australia. Welcome to Australia. You're in Australia because you're listening to my voice. Fuck. I am Australian, but people tell me I have an accent. Personally, I don't hear it, but, you know, that's just because I've lived being me my whole life, and that sounds really stupid, but it's true. Like, you know, you never hear your own accent. It's just like, you know, this is how you think you talk. If I do have an accent, the explanation is probably, you know, I was born in England. My family is a mix of English, Welsh, Kiwis, Australians, like a whole bunch of shit. I grew up in Australia watching and listening to American TV. Like, that's just how I grew up, and that's pretty much how I learned to talk. So if I have a wee bit of, like, a slur or an accent or even, like, stupid things, that's just how I talk. Alban. Thanks, man.
It's good to know.
Thank you for letting me know. Okay, my controller became disconnected. That's great. Hey, there we go. I'm playing on a PS3 and I'm using a PS4 controller that connects and disconnects at will because my old cord is fucked. And because the three PS3 controllers I have are shitty knockoffs. Well, one real one and two shitty knockoffs that don't work super great that I bought on eBay for like $10. Ow! I hate the camera. I hate the camera in this game. You can get fucked. You can get 110% fucked. I missed some gems. That's great. This is me proving how good I am at this fucking game. Huh. You enjoying this, guys? You know, we all enjoying this. If the half-hour format doesn't particularly work that well, because it is a long time to play, I might cut it down to 15 minutes, 15-minute episodes, and try to upload two a day, which will be frickin' hard as shit, because Australia's internet is crap. Just not as good as America. Like this, Gnork with the club cannot be charged, but a quick flame, that should defeat them. Yes, well, thank you. I love these first couple of dragons. Like, the dragons in the first few worlds actually give you advice, and then later on you get about three or four that are all just like, thank you for releasing me. You'll see. We'll get to that part, and you'll see my frustration at these fucks. I'm just like, thank you for releasing me. No advice? Really? Man, that would've been great. Would've been great if you gave me just a little bit of advice. Man, that'd've been cool. That'd been super cool, man. I'm gonna save. I'm not gonna save here. If I save here, I'll be stuck in this fucking world forever. Or at least until the next time I save. I don't want that shit. No one wants that shit, man. That shit bananas. Hang on. How much time have I got left? Like 8 minutes. Maybe a little less. Struggles to fill 30 minutes. Isn't gonna make it as a Let's Player. I'm gonna do the Speedway level because it's just annoying to do anyway, and why not, you know? Like, if I get it done, then it's done. Sunny flight. Let's all have a sunny, sunny flight. Yeah. Yeah, good. Okay. I hope no one just heard me crack my neck, because that is hella gross. Oh, this level. Yeah. Primary colors, motherfucker. Yeah. I remember these speedways in the first game because it was literally every item working around, like, primary colors or some shit like that. Like the red barrels and the green, greeny greens. You know? Them greeny greens. Where is the first greeny green? Okay. Actually, let's try the yellow chest. I seem to recall that there's a yellow chest in every one of these stages. Like, the yellow chests are collectible in each of these frickin' stages. On turn! Do it! There's the last one. Boom jam. Okay, now we gotta go do the greens. And there's some blue stuff around here somewhere, I swear to God. It's like, oh, no, I'm here, I'm collecting them. Stop it. Stop timing me. Don't do it. I have so much to live for. No. I have time now. Come on. Oh my God. This is me stealing jokes from the Game Grumps. How am I doing? Am I funny yet? Am I a funny guy? Is this funny? Do I look like a clown to you? And there I go stealing jokes from... Well, not even jokes, just lines from movies. Because why not? Right? Like, why not? Why not steal lines from movies, huh? Huh? Fucking Jesus! Why were there two of you? On top of each other, jeez. Not that there's anything wrong with that, of course. Two Norks being on top of each other, that's totally normal, man. Like, if you don't like Norks, then you're Norkist. Or Norkophobic. That's not cool, man. Not in the world we live in. Not anymore. Jeez. Freaking Norkophobes these days, man. Can't just walk down the street, two Norks in hand. Like, hand in hand, man. It's discrimination is what it is. If you didn't get the sense that I'm a little bit liberal by now, you don't know me very well. And that's a shame, because I like you guys. Fuck me. Yeah, okay, let's try this again. I hate this level so much. I hate these freaking speedway levels. They're always so goddamn hard. I got distracted by my phone. That's great. That's fantastic. I hope that didn't stop recording. Yeah, I'll try again. Fuck me. Okay. Fucking yeah, that's one. Two. Three. Four. Five. And six. And let's go do the planes. Come on! Fucking fly into my flames. Fly right into my flames. Come on, yeah. See if I can, like, kill two birds with one stone. Jesus. Why is this so hard? Okay, yeah, that's a good. Gotta catch up to you. Flame you. Flame war. Flame arena. Beautiful. Two. Come on, I can do this. How many arches did I get? Like, nearly all of them? This is probably, like, the worst way to do this. Don't use this as, like, a guide, because I am not good at this. Yeah! Okay, I might get it. I might actually get it. Let's see how I'm doing. Yeah, okay. Frickin' 7 seconds. Okay. Game face. Whoa! Okay. Seriously. Not okay. Okay. One more. Come on, Reese. You can do it. Fuck yeah! Okay. I make that... That seems... That's a lot harder than it seems. Trust me. That shit is annoying as shit. Hey, I got 120. No, I do not want to try that again. Thank you, sir. I'm going back to the home world. I'm going to save my game. And that'll probably be it for this episode. This is one episode down, man. And if you hear tapping, that's me on my phone. Because, that was stupid. I need to stop my timer, because I, like, set a timer up. And, yeah, it's gonna go off in, like, a minute. Yeah, okay. That's one episode down. We did it. We finished our first episode. That wasn't as bad as I thought. Anyway, I'm Reese. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more of this, whatever the fuck it is, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Maybe like the video, leave some shitty comments wherever you want. You know, that'd be cool. And I will see you next time, guys. Until then, stay cool. Love you lots. Bye-bye.